Hello, Tarot viewers. Welcome to our Good Morning Tarot. Okay, so it's good to start the day with a short tarot reading. Now, let us try to see what is our main energy for today. Well, a chapter has closed. Okay. Well, it was a painful chapter. It affected your body a great deal. For some of you, maybe you might have suffered a lot of back pain. Some of you, pain in the neck, pain in the shoulder, pain in the back, especially the lower one. So it affected all your chakras also. For some of you, maybe you need to, you need to attend to some body pains. No, if you need to seek consult, do seek consult. But the chapter has closed. It's something that you cannot do anything anymore. But the sun is beginning to rise. Suddenly, what came to me right now is that it says, yeah, it is darkest. It is darkest before the sunrise. So, well, here the sun is beginning to rise already. So the dark moment is passing already, and there's hope. A new chapter is beginning. So if this chapter has really been trying for you, don't worry, a new chapter is opening. So the main energy right now is the closing of a chapter. So a new chapter is about to begin. So take how it resonates with you right now. Maybe something is closing, or maybe something already just closed. No. And now, what do we expect? What should we do now that the chapter has closed? So, okay, just be yourself. Just try to, and remain on fire. Be on fire. Okay, you see here, she's holding a wand, and somehow the wand is there. You know, I feel that the wand is also a sort of like a sign of having good boundaries. When you hold the wand like that, nobody immediately approaches you, because you can immediately hit them with the wand. Okay, but you are a little bit smiling. So in a certain sense, there is a gentleness in you, but it's like also you're saying, be careful. Okay, I have good boundaries. Okay, it's like that. And right now, I think another one is, be aware of the guidance that will be coming from your spirit guides at this time. But remain on fire and be aware of the presence of the divine. So now that a new chapter is opening, be receptive to the presence of the divine in your life. Be receptive also to the guidance that the universe is giving you. Be receptive also, because the universe might be giving you a new gift or a new inspiration in order to start the new chapter. But just be yourself, okay? Don't be afraid to be who you truly are. Just like the Queen of Wands, she is one of those queens who, when you see, she dresses unconventionally. There's a certain relaxed energy in her. Like she's not afraid to relax. So in a certain sense also, when a chapter has closed, it's good also to spend some time alone, spend some time to relax. No, this one, somehow there is a relaxed atmosphere here, but at the same time, you feel that there is an inner strength coming, emanating from her. Okay, so this is what I feel, what we should, a thing that we can be right now after a club chapter has closed. And to remain emotionally stable also, to remain confident, remain on fire, but at the same time also to be emotionally stable. The cups behind somehow symbolizes also somebody who tries to maintain a good relationship with everyone. So even if the chapter has closed, sometimes instead of sort of having hurt feelings with other people, it is good to maintain good relationship with them. Okay, you understand that the chapter has to close, but there is also a certain, you still try to be civil with the people if it had been a painful situation. But at the same time, you see him, his hands are akimbo, as if he is confident. So in a certain sense, he deals with the people also in a nice way, in a mature way, but at the same time, good boundaries. So I think the main energy here, the main thing here is to maintain good boundaries, but at the same time also try to maintain good relationships with people. So yeah, these are people who are stable. Sitting down makes you a little bit more stable and ready to act. So in a certain sense, you are a little bit in the receptive mode right now, but anytime you need to act, you are ready to act if needed. Okay, so this is what you can see right now. So a chapter has closed, so just be in a receptive mode, rest a little bit, spend more time in silence and solitude, be receptive to the guidance of the universe at this time, and try to maintain good relationships with everybody. So this is what I can see for you right now. Okay, now maybe we can ask for two more cards from the universe, a little bit more clarification. Okay, yeah, you have a disarming personality. I think it's let bygones be bygones. This is the one that comes to me right now. Even if this has been a painful situation for some of you, I think the message is like this one, no? Maintain good relationships. Bury the swords, no? Bury the hatchets. It's you see the two swords there, they are being buried. The other swords is taking away. So it's like try not to argue anymore. Try not to. It's just don't avoid verbal wars. No, this person is removing all the swords so that he can avoid fighting war with this army behind him. So in a certain sense, it's like bearing the hatchets, bearing the swords, so that. Burying the hatches or burying the swords so that there won't be any more altercations. So I think if you are very diplomatic and you honestly tell them, I don't want any argument anymore. Let us, if we really cannot agree, let us just agree to disagree. Okay. And just respect each other's point of view. Something like that. So it's having a good boundary, but at the same time also respecting their points of view. Okay, their point of view. So in a certain sense, you just agree to disagree, and maybe you can say, maybe we can talk about things that will be beneficial for both of us. Okay, so trying to get a win-win situation, but at the same time respecting each other's point of view. So it's like that. It's not going into war anymore. You remove the possibility of going into war, and I think if you do that, stability again will be restored, and there will be celebration again. So in a certain sense, yeah, it's more of being in a removing the war and working for peace, and I think this approach will lead to stability, and in the future maybe regaining the friendship maybe in the future, or at least regaining a certain relationship where everybody is just comfortable. Instead of fighting, there will be more of a celebratory kind of relationship. If you can go to a win-win situation, then sooner or later, then maybe it can mend whatever relationship has been strained, and the chance for celebration is again there. Well, one last. And it's time to really leave behind the closed chapter. The spilled cup, I feel, is a closed chapter. Now, the universe is opening you something new, giving you a new gift. I know there will be moments of mourning. It has been painful, but it's time for you to let go. And you need to turn around and face the new cups that are being given to you. So, yeah. Part of the closing of the chapter is Yeah, there will be some pain. There will be maybe some regrets, no? But turn around. There are new cups here. And they are waiting for you already. The new chapter is waiting for you. It's time for you to close the chapter. And I see the bridge. I feel the bridge is important there to maintain good communications. I think it has something to do with the Seven of Swords. And if we do that, the Four of Wands awaits us. The Nine of Cups and the Seven of Swords. I think the secret here for you to be able to move forward in this situation that you are in. Well, I hope it resonates with you. This is our reading for the Good Morning Tarot. Now let us go to the second part, which is the self-care tip. Okay, everyone, let us now go to our self-care tip for today. The phrase is from Eleanor Roosevelt. And her message is, remember always that you not only have the right to be an individual, you have an obligation to be one. What immediately comes to my mind is that all of us has a special song to sing. That is why we are placed in this world. We are part of the chorus of the universe, and each one of us has a special line to contribute to this orchestra, to this chorus of the universe, the choir of the cosmos, the concert of the cosmos. If we don't sing our part, then the song will not be complete. So we need a contribution, and it is something that is an obligation. We need to be who we truly are. We need to listen to the inspiration that is burning inside our hearts. We need to really sing that special song, because if we do not do that, nobody else will ever be doing that. So the advisor is set a small goal for your day. Well, maybe it's like a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So if you have an inspiration right now in your life, take one step forward. Like for example, if you are inspired to learn something new, maybe one step forward is to try to get a book that is related to that and start reading that book. Or if you are inspired to learn something new, maybe you can always enroll yourself to an online course, no? Or maybe get a free information from the internet regarding this new inspiration that you have. If you are interested to start a new relationship with someone, sometimes all you have to do is to start with hello. They say love begins with one hello. Okay, the hardest part is over. Now it's easier letting go. Okay, now, so if you have, I think that song can help you if you are inspired to start a new relationship. No, so just take one small step or set one small goal for today. Maybe if the inspiration that you have right now, the thing that you feel is the song that you're going to sing, taking one step each day closer towards that inspiration, I think is much better than just sitting in one corner and just daydreaming about it. So just do one thing today. One step closer. One step closer. In 7 days, you already made 7 steps closer. Anyway, so this is what I can think of it, or a reflection that I can think of at this time regarding, singing that special song, no? Being that individual which we feel all of us are obligated to be, that special individual, that special unique person that is us. They say it's easier to compete with ourselves rather than competing with others, because when you compete with others, you try to be others, no? If you try to be the best other person you can be, you cannot be able to do that, because the other person was meant to be the best them. So you will only be the second best. But nobody can be the best you. You are the one who is meant to be the best you. So just be your best you. Okay. Internal self-care. It says here, often the activity of goal setting lives in the mind. We mentally process past, present, and future hopes and desires, then formulate a plan about how to next achieve them. Today, let the goal setting reside in your emotional body. Close your eyes and conjure a scene or situation in which you feel like you are the most you. A space that makes you feel good. Now, instead of formulating a plan that you can check off the list, simply remember that part of yourself as you move through your day. The you that feels like the most you. Okay, you try to see which is the you that you feel most relaxed to be with. Okay. The one that you like being, one thing that you can tell to the world, this is me. Okay. Even the smallest pebble makes ripples that may fill the whole lake. So just try to see what is, maybe you can think of once, what is that one specific character that defines me? And today I will just continually think, this is me. For example, that one me has this special laugh, so don't be ashamed to have that special laugh. That one me is a little bit quirky, and people find it joy being in that quirky self. So I will remain my quirky self, okay, something like that. External self-care. What has your role tended to be in the various communities you have been a part of throughout your life? Do you seek the same role over and over, or do your role change as you grow older? Are there roles you avoid? Without judgment, simply take stock of the roles you have played over time and what might be learned from them. Okay, some people are called to be leaders, and people somehow feel it by intuition. Now, I remember before, when I was still young, whenever we have group activities, I always chosen as one of the group leaders, and I got tired of it, and I said, no, I don't want to be a group leader anymore. And for a short while, I just disappeared from the scene. And then I started looking for who I truly am. And then finally, when I found who I truly am, I realized that the reason why people try to make me a leader is because they get inspired when I am with them. So I realized, yeah, I can still inspire people without we always being in the limelight. But every once in a while, I have to accept it that sometimes I have to be in the limelight in order to sing that special message that will inspire people. So sooner or later, I realized there are moments when you really have to lead. So I had to accept it, and I accepted it. And now I find joy. Even now, this, what I am doing right now here in my channel, it's continually inspiring people. Just taking one small step a day. And I am happy because I realized that, part of the role I have to play is to inspire people, and I have to accept it. It is something that is with me, and I cannot deny that. Yes, I still enjoy being out of the limelight, like right now when I do my channel, when I do videos in my channel, I don't show myself, but I continue to inspire because I realize that that was my calling, and this is the me that I am called to be. So yeah, learning to also discern what is our usual contribution to the community, and learning to accept it and learning to love it, because you know that it is part of us. And that is the song that we need to sing to the world. Well, I hope that it has helped you right now. This ends our Good Morning Tarot for today. Thank you for the likes and the comments you've given to the channel. Thank you for subscribing. I hope to see you again in our succeeding videos. Until that time, may God continue to bless your ways.